They come from all across the world, each with varying levels of skill. But they all have one goal, to become the ultimate champion. The challengers compete across a 4-stage obstacle course that tests their speed, balance, dexterity, and ultimate skill. And whilst many will try, very few, if any, shall succeed. This is Ninja Warrior of Halo! Hello guys, and welcome to another episode of Ninja Warrior of Halo. Time for episode 3. We're into the final session of stage 1. We have the final 6 contestants here to take on the course today. Can any of them join the 3 men who have already made it through to stage 2? Well, time to find out. First contestant on the course today is an old favourite. He's now known as SOCTX Odin, but most people will know him as Bamboo Nightmare. He's a regular on these sorts of ninja obstacle courses, but more well known for not doing well at all, rarely ever getting past the first obstacle to be honest. Still, he's here to take on this course. How will he do? 75 seconds for 6 obstacles. And we're off. First obstacle is the rapid climb, and he's fallen at the first jump. He keeps up his tradition of falling early. Next up is Bamboo's friend, Emerging Corpse. He's also competed on several Ninja Warrior courses before, including Spartan Warrior. How will he do on the course? 75 seconds, and we're off. He's off on the rapid climb. He doesn't make the same mistake as Bamboo Nightmare, but he falls into one of the gaps. Now he's going to need to get himself out. As we've seen in previous episodes, if you waste too much time getting stuck on this obstacle, then you won't have enough time to complete the rest of the course. And Corpse is not really going anywhere, to be honest. He's just jumping up and down. Hey, no, Corpse, that's cheating, no grenade tricks. No, not naughty Corpse, bad Corpse. But anyway, he's used it to get out the gap, but he's fallen straight back in again. And he's using another grenade. Well, either way, he's run out of grenades now, so if he doesn't make it this time, he's pretty much stuck. But he has made it this time, and he's through the first obstacle, but he's only got 25 seconds left on the clock. This is certainly going to be a timeout, I'm afraid. No doubt about it, he's made it through onto the super slide, and he's gone down that as well, but he's got 10 seconds left, and the buzzer has started. Listen to that new buzzer that I've introduced to you guys. So he's going, yep, he's on the stepping stones, 2-1, ran out of time on the stepping stones. Reminds me of what a previous contestant did in the last episode. Well, as we look towards the finish line on the course, can our next contestant get there? He'll be hoping to get there because, you know who's up next? It's none other than Re95. How's he gonna do on the course? He is the uncrowned king of Spartan Warrior. He's come closer than anybody else to defeating the course, and now he's here to take on this course. He's off on the rapid climb already in about 5 seconds. And he's off onto the pole cross. As I say, he's got further than anybody else on Spartan Warrior, and now he'll be looking to achieve glory on this course. And he's already doing very well. He's onto the hill climb, and he's only spent about 20 seconds on the course. He continues to move fast through the stepping stones. He's obviously trying to get the fastest time. He's well known for his super speed. And he's on to the final obstacle, the mountain climb, with 40 seconds still on the clock. He will certainly make it, surely. Surely nothing's going to stop him now. He's gone up the left-hand side, he's almost at the top, he's onto the left stone, and he's finished! He's finished it with 25.46 seconds still on the clock. Fastest time so far. Well done to Ree. Well, I haven't got a Ninja Killer or a Spartan Wipeout for you guys today. Instead, I'm just going to make a small announcement. If you are interested in competing in a future tournament of Ninja Warrior of Halo, then subscribe to the channel, Extreme UK Gaming, and leave a comment or send me a message telling me your gamertag and why you would like to compete on the show. The main reason why I'm asking you to subscribe is so that you'll know when I release the video telling you when the release date is, mainly. Anyway, we're halfway through and we're on to our next contestant, who is MudMonkey35. He's off on the course and he's into the rapid climb. We're going for an overhead shot, and he's onto the pole cross, doing pretty well, doing okay for time at the moment. Ooh, nearly slipped off there, that was close. We have seen a few contestants fall, and he's onto the super slide and he's cleared that as well. Now he's heading on to the hill climb. Hasn't provided too much problem for many contestants, but he's had to clear it on his second attempt, and now he's onto the stepping stones. He's onto the second stone. He's onto the third stone. Oh no! No he hasn't! He's fallen! Oh no! Disappointing for MudMonkey. Let's have a look at a replay of that. Okay, he clears the super slide, and he heads up the hill climb, fails on his first attempt, gets up on his second attempt, and then he gets onto the stepping stones. Still had plenty of time on the clock, but on the third stone, it looks... Yeah, I think it looks like he undershoots it. We'll get a replay from this angle, and we'll see. Yep, he undershoots it. Disappointing for MudMonkey. Well, second last guy. Next up is Sideshow Freak, with lots of X's in the middle of his name. How will he do on the course? Will he be a freak, or will he be a success? Let's find out as he pushes up the rapid climb, and he's going pretty good as well. Cleared that in about 6 seconds. He's across on the pole cross, doing well. And now he's onto the super slide, and he's gone down that pretty quick as well. Very fast so far. Obviously wanting to make sure he's got plenty of time for the later parts of the obstacle. Or of the course, I should say. Sorry, my bad. He's onto the stepping stones. Got to be careful here. Yep. Fourth stone. Onto the fifth stone, and he's through, and he's onto the last obstacle, the mountain climb. Which side will he go up? He's going up the left-hand side, same side as Ree. That seems to be the side that most contestants are going up, to be honest. He's almost at the top. He looks like he's going to make it. Oh no, no, he's fallen! Oh my goodness! Wait, did anybody just see that banshee? If you recall the previous episode, Epic Landlord was messing around with the banshee. Looks like he's still up to his old tricks. But Sideshow Freak's managed to climb back up, and he's finished with 9.19 seconds still on the clock. Well done to Sideshow. Well, if we have a look at a replay, we see Epic in the background, and we see Sideshow Freak speeding through the first half of the course, and as a result, he could afford to make this small mistake at the top of the mountain climb, which could have proven costly had he not had plenty of time still on the clock. And as a result, he could afford to climb up the mountain twice, and this time finish in time. So well done to Sideshow Freak. Crossing the finish line in just under 10 seconds. Well done to him. Well, we're on to our final contestant, Epic Landlord. He's out of the banshee and back onto his feet. How will he do on the course? He's already up the rapid climb and he's onto the pole cross. And he gets across that as well, and he's onto the super slide. Clears that as well. Fifth person to get to the hill climb today. We've had a lot of success so far, and he's up that as well, and he's onto the stepping stones. Two people have already been defeated or ran out of time here. How will he do on it? He's onto the fourth stone, onto the fifth stone, and cleared it. And he's onto the last obstacle, the mountain climb. He's well known for his forging skills. He's gone up the middle path, and now, yep, he's moved on to the right-hand side. As I say, he's well known for his forging skills, for some of the crazy ideas he comes up with, and which includes multiple shows that he likes to do. And he's made it to the top, and he finishes with 17.5 seconds still on the clock. Well, with that, he's the sixth man through to stage two. And with that, we have half a dozen men through, as I say. First, we have Re95, finishing with the fastest time as we saw today, followed closely by Darkest Sick, then USS Defiant, then Epic Landlord, who we just saw finish the course, followed by returning contestant Yovgost, and finally Sideshow Freak, coming in with the slowest time of just under 10 seconds. Well, we'll see them in the next episode take on stage 2. Can any of them get to the third stage? And maybe even get to the final stage? Well, you'll just have to wait and find out. I've been Hunter Unit 751. Until next time, goodbye.